three ahadith that prove that a prophet can still come after the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ahmadi Muslims hold the belief that the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the Khatamun Nabiyyin, the seal of the prophets. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "La nabiyya ba'di," there is no prophet after me, and we as Ahmadi Muslims fully accept this hadith. We also believe that no law-bearing prophet can come after the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. However, it is possible for a follower prophet, one who follows the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and is from among his ummah, to attain the status of prophethood as a subordinate. Here are three ahadith that support this view. 1. The Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when speaking of the Messiah of the latter days, referred to him as Nabiullah Isa, the Prophet of Allah Isa. He repeated this 4 times, the Prophet of Allah Isa, making it very clear that the person who was to appear in the latter days to reform the Muslims would be a prophet. 2. When the son of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Ibrahim, passed away, the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if he had lived, he would have become a prophet. Now, it's worth noting that the verse of the Holy Quran in which the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is called Khatamun Nabiyyin, seal of the prophets, was revealed before the death of Ibrahim. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam could have said, if Ibrahim had lived, he could never become a prophet because I am the seal of the prophets. However, the fact that he did not say this, and he said that he would become a prophet if he had lived, shows that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam interpreted the seal of prophethood to mean that a follower prophet can indeed appear after him. And this is also the Ahmadiyya view. 3. In another hadith, the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam speaks about the establishment of Khilafah in Islam. He says that after his prophethood, Khilafah will be established on the precepts of prophethood, which will then be raised after some time. This will be followed by despotic rule, which will then be raised. After this will come tyrannical rule, which will also be raised after some time. And finally, the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Khilafah ala minhaj an-nubuwa, Khilafah on the precepts of prophethood will be established. Now, this makes it very clear that Khilafah can only be established after the advent of a prophet. And this is what all Muslims believe. They believe that when Jesus, the Messiah, will return, after him, Khilafah will be re-established. However, we as Ahmadi Muslims believe that Allah has already sent that person. He has already appointed a person from among the ummah of the Prophet Muhammad, a follower of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He has raised him as a prophet, and after him, Khilafah was established. That person is Hazrat Mirza Ghulam Ahmad of Qadian, may peace be upon him, after whom Khilafah was re-established.